Jessie Nilo has been a passionate artist for as long as she can remember. It's a love she longed to share with members of her Vineyard Boise church family.
I was at the time going to college for art, and as I was growing artistically, the chasm in my heart grew because I was growing spiritually at one location and growing artistically at a different location, and the two worlds never intersected. And so it left me feeling pretty frustrated because I could never talk about God with my art friends, and I could never talk about art with my church friends.
So she began thinking about starting a ministry for fellow artists at her church, something she admits she knew very little about.
I honestly didn't know, except that we could talk about things that were meaningful to us. And we could see, because I didn't know, so we could see how those two areas in our life could intersect. That's really all I had. And maybe we could make some Sunday school posters or something.
Fast forward 10 years. Today, Nilo oversees Vine Arts at her church, a ministry complete with a studio and art gallery. Professional and amateur artists are encouraged to explore and develop their God-given creativity through workshops and other hands-on opportunities. This backdrop was painted by a group of the ministry's budding artists.
This is a place of safety. It's a place of spiritual growth. And Jesus is our focus. The Holy Spirit has infinite creativity, and we're tethered to His Spirit. And He's going to increase our creativity as individuals.
This art gallery located inside Vineyard Church highlights the work of artists from both inside and outside the church. Its purpose is to encourage people to reflect and contemplate about life and to worship God, the greatest creator of all.
Sherry Cofield says the arts ministry helped her find healing from an abusive past. Today, she uses the same tools to help others heal.
For me, it became not about the art, but about the relationship and about love. Mm-hmm. And so there's something about doing art that really loosened these people up. Yeah. And they would start talking about their lives and their problems, and then we can introduce the love thing, right? Mm-hmm. And so for me, now when I create, I'm more freer in my art, but I'm having a conversation with the Lord as I'm creating.
It's a real feeding ground for creativity. And people who are broken and shattered, whether they're dealing with depression or addictions or just grief, they find a lot of solace here. And they can find that healing. They have caring people that they can just spend some time with when they walk in.
Vine Arts includes photographers, painters, and more. The ministry was a big draw for Brad and Debbie Keith, who moved here from California just to take part. And while the big emphasis on the arts is what inspired them to come, they say the spiritual climate is what affected them most.
See, they have Bible studies in here, so this isn't necessarily just the arts.
When we got here and we met the people and saw so many creatives, we just felt at home. So we packed up everything and away we came. We've been happy since we've been here. We've been never looked back.
Nilo says the ministry also appeals to the unchurched, who are welcomed with love and no pressure.
A lot of times they'll end up, you know, checking out the church and going deeper in that way with their discipleship, and it's okay if they don't too. They still have us, and who else is praying for those people?
Charlene Aaron, CBN News, Boise, Idaho.